My name is Arundhati and welcome back to the Aham Yoga channel. These videos are a part of our Do More Yoga campaign for January, where every day we release one short video with a few more yoga poses for you to practice at home. Remember to hashtag Do More Yoga and Aham Yoga so we can keep track of your videos and your posts every day till the end of the month. And who knows, you might just be the lucky winner at the end of the month. Okay, so today we're going to focus on upper body strength, the basic poses that will help bring upper body strength. And eventually in the weeks ahead, we will add more and more poses. The intensity will slowly start to increase. But for today, we're going to start with a couple of poses that are absolutely basic. And especially for us women, we tend to be more flexible and fluid, and that's how nature has built us. So it is really important to keep working on some upper body strength regularly. Like they say, if you don't use it, you will lose it. So we'll do a few poses today that are largely focused on your building strength in your wrists, your arms, your shoulders, the front of your chest or your pecs, and a little bit of core. I want you to remember that when you are building upper body strength, it's not just about the upper body. It's equally about keeping your lower body, your legs, your feet, your everything in your lower body engaged as well. In any yoga pose, we don't just work on one part. It's not a microscopic approach where we only work on one particular part of the body. Even though the focus may be on one particular part, we are completely engaging the whole body, okay? And that's why yoga is one of the reasons why yoga is so great for full body awareness, all right? So let's get started. We do have our little puppy Munch here who has taken over my mat. He seems to like this mat more than his own. So we're gonna work around him, all right? So let's get started. Our first pose for today is called high plank. And high plank is a great way for us to get oriented with what upper body strength means and how to really do it. So let's get started, okay? So all you need is a yoga mat today, unless somebody's stolen your mat, okay? What you want to do is begin in downward facing dog. If you go back a couple of videos, we did put up one on the do's and don'ts of downward facing dog. So if you're new and you're not familiar with Adhomukha Svanasana, make sure you go back and watch that video before you start getting into down dog here, okay? So opening both palms up, keeping your palms a shoulder distance apart, you curl your toes in, lift your hips up, and move into your first Adhomukha Svanasana or downward facing dog. This pose here is great to build upper body strength, okay? But from down dog, we're not gonna stay here. From down dog, you move your weight forward and you come into what is commonly referred to as high plank. Your shoulders are over your wrists, your palms are completely open, you're pushing against the mat, you're lifting your knees and pressing out through the feet, the heels in particular. Now watch my hips. If your hips drop below shoulder level, then you're not really in plank pose. You want to keep your hips in line with your shoulders. Draw the navel in and tuck the front hip points towards the ribs a little more. Holding here, and as you exhale, pick your hips up and move back to down dog. Let's do that a few more times. Inhale, come forward, neck is long. Exhale, push back, Adhomukha Svanasana. Inhale, moving forward, and exhale, pulling back. Inhale, moving forward, share the weight equally between your hands and your feet, though you'll feel it more in your arms. Exhale, drawing back. Inhale, move forward. And last one, exhale, pulling back. Drop both knees down and rest here for a moment if you need to. But the important thing to remember is when you do your repetitions, remind yourself of what you need to engage, what you need to hold, what you should not be doing for safer alignment. If you are someone who has weak wrists, it is a good idea to put some amount of weight on it unless there's something more going on with your wrist. The only way we can strengthen the wrist is really to put weight on it, okay? But if you have a wrist injury, and even if you don't, the next pose is a great one to practice every now and then. So you want your shoulders over your elbows. You interlock both palms completely and you put them on the mat. Keeping the shoulders over the elbows, curl your toes in and just walk back into low plank. Okay? Again, watch what the hips do. Keep your hips engaged in line with your shoulders. Draw the shoulders back. Wake the legs up. Lift your knees, lift your thighs, and really keep the lower part of your body fully engaged. Take a few breaths here. Hold for about 30 seconds, maybe lesser. And then to come out of it, just drop your knees down. And you can just rest all the way back. And then slowly come up and repeat either high plank and forearm plank or one of the two, again depending on how much time you have. Okay, so those are great poses to do to begin your practice, to strengthen your upper body. Okay, we'll start doing more in the weeks ahead. So keep watching. Thank you for watching and subscribing. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.